The first video I ever uploaded on my YouTube channel was a video called Ranking All My Nintendo 64 Games. And today I'm thinking about doing episode 5 in that series. It was a couple of months ago I did my Ranking All My Wii U Games. So today I'm finally gonna do it. I'm gonna do my Ranking All My Switch Games. I have put off doing this video for quite some time now, and that's because I'm always getting new Switch games. And I want to play those games, so I can have them on this list. But then I play them, and I get new ones, and you get the gist. I have 31 games I'm gonna rank today, and I don't have the time to talk about them in depth at all, really. So I guess it's gonna be a quickie. Anyway, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. I upload game-related content every week. Also, like the video if you like it. Let's get this video to 20 thumbs up, at least. Yes, let's do that. And let's get going to the ranking video now. As I said, I have 31 games I'm gonna rank today, but sadly I have 3 games I don't feel comfortable with putting on my list, and that is Tales of Wisperia, Starlink, and Owlboy. These 3 games I haven't even started up once, so I can't really rank them at all. The rest of the games I have all played a little bit at least. Some a lot, but at least some. On number 31 I have a digital game, the worst game in my collection, and that is sadly Snake Pass. Snake Pass is one of the first games I think I ever had on my Switch. Snake Pass and Breath of the Wild. And I mean, Breath of the Wild was a little bit better. I don't really like Snake Pass at all. It's a gimmick, nothing else. On number 30, I'm gonna put Rime. I didn't play much of this game. I got it as a gift from my mother, I believe. And I started it up, it looked intriguing. It wasn't really intriguing when I got into it. I didn't get far. It was a little bit laggy, kind of boring. I don't really like it, but it's better than Snake Pass, I guess. On number 29, I have Super Bomberman. This game, it's okay, but it's not a good Bomberman. It's not the best Bomberman. I don't really like it. I played it a couple of times with my friends. Didn't really like it. It's kind of meh. On 28, I'm gonna put Dark Souls, and I haven't played a lot of it. Not really. I watch a lot of playthroughs. I watch my partner play it, but I mean, I don't like it. I like the lore. I love the lore, but I don't like it as a game. It's scary. I don't really like it. So therefore, it's on 28. Now I'm gonna do a quick run through of 4 games that I have digitally on my Switch. On 27, I have Tesla vs. Lovecraft. I have made a video of this game. Go check it out if you haven't done it already. On 26, I have Mushroom Wars. On 25, I have Knights of Pen and Paper. And 24, Golf Story. On 23 I have Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze. It's a fun 2D platformer game. I'm not much of a platformer though, but it's good, but I have better games. On 22 I have Super Mario Party. It's not the best Mario Party. It is a kinda good Super Mario Party. I laugh my ass off playing this with my mom and dad. Therefore, it's a little bit higher up than the rest of the games, but it's kinda meh. But kind of fun, so 22. On number 21, I'm gonna put Octopath Traveler. This is a great game, a fantastic game. Go play it if you haven't done it already. But why is it on number 21 then? Well, I have games I love more than this one. So, therefore, it's kind of low on the list. But it's a good game. On number 20, I have Super Mario Maker 2. I have done a live stream with this game, so go watch it if you haven't done it already. It's a great game. I mean, it's good. I can't see any faults in it, but I'm not much for platformers and the 2D Mario games. So it's a good game, but I have games I love more than this one. On number 19, I'm gonna put Bayonetta, and I guess Bayonetta 1 and 2 because it's on the same disc, but I haven't gotten to the second game yet, so see this as just Bayonetta 1, I guess. I love the art style, the graphics, the story is interesting. It's a fantastic game, but I haven't gotten that far into it, so I haven't really gotten hooked on it yet. So therefore, number 19. On number 18, I have a little digital game I bought, and that is This is the Police. I have played this game quite a lot with my partner and it was really fun. So if you haven't played it, do it. It's fantastic. It's really interesting and fun. And now we have This is the Police 2, I think. I like this game, so number 18. On 17 I have Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, and I didn't really enjoy it that much in the beginning when I played it. I had a little playthrough on my channel playing this one, but then I stopped playing it on my channel and just played it by myself, and it was by that time I really started to enjoy it and I started hunting shinies, and it's really fun, but it's a remake, so number 17. Yeah, right. I forgot I had Metapod. On number 16 we have a free game, and that is Tetris 99 that I downloaded from the Switch eShop. And it's a really fun game. I live streamed that one as well on my channel, so go check it out if you haven't done it already. I have always loved playing Tetris, and I mean, this Tetris version is fantastic, and now you can get like custom backgrounds and all that stuff. It's a nice Tetris, what can I say? On number 15 I'm gonna put Flame in the Flood, and this is a game I have talked about on my channel in a video titled 5 Indie Games You Should Play or something like that. I will link it up in the corner for you to watch. But this game is absolutely fantastic, I love it. This is a physical copy from Super Rare Games and I will treasure this forever. It's really fun, the country music in it, it's great. Like it, love it, play it. On number 14 I will put the beautiful game Okami. I imported a physical edition from Japan. It didn't get a physical edition in the West. I got so mad, so I imported it. It's beautiful, I love this game. The music is amazing, the art style is amazing. It's a beautiful game. On number 13 I have Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. And this is a game that's really amazing, really fun. I haven't finished this yet. I played it a lot when we first bought it, and then other games came and we started playing them instead. But it's really fun and I really like it, so it's getting a pretty high place on my list. On number 12 I have Dragon Quest Builders 2. When I saw the Dragon Quest Builders 1 I wasn't really intrigued. I didn't think it would be a game I would like. I played the demo and I was bored, the tutorial was so tedious, it felt like the whole game would be a tutorial, not my thing. But then the second one came and I was like, but I really want to like it. So I bought it and I like it. It's really fun, great, still feels a little bit tutorial-y, but it's fun to build and just do stuff. So yes, this is a great game. On number 11 I have The Escapists 2. Which I bought from the Nintendo Switch eShop and played a lot with my partner once again. It was super fun. I love this game so much. It was a little bit buggy here and there, but I don't know, maybe they patched that up since then. It's a fantastic game to play with a friend and I love it so much, and I want to jump into it again soon to play a prison or two. So now we have gotten to the top 10 favorite Switch games, and on number 10 I'm gonna put Oxenfree. Oxenfree is a game that I bought from the Nintendo Switch eShop, and I'm so mad at myself that I didn't get the physical limited edition from Limited Run Games or Super Rare Games, wherever it was, because I wanted it so badly and I didn't get it, and now I'm angry at myself. But it's a great game. I love the music, the atmosphere, it's so mysterious. It's amazing, I love it so much, and therefore it is on number 10 on my list of 31 Switch games. On number 9 I'm gonna put Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and I have livestreamed this game as well, so go check it out if you haven't done it already. This is a great game, it's the ultimate Smash game. Everyone is here, Joker is here from Persona, oh my god, it's a great game, really fun. But I have games I love even more than this one. On number 8 I'm gonna put Valkyria Chronicles 4. When I saw that the next Valkyria Chronicles game would come to Switch, because the rest of them had been on PlayStation 4, 3, Vita, I was like, we Nintendo fans, we're getting the good stuff. Oh my god, I was so excited. I love the first Valkyria Chronicles game, and this is like the first game, but just a little bit different. And you don't need to fix something that is already perfect. This is a great game, I love it so much. Perfect. On number 7, I have Cadence of Hyrule. I made a video about this game, a little review, go check it out. This is a great game, I love it. A little bit short for some, for the price it is, but it's amazing. The remixes, it's Zelda, oh my god, it's just great. I love this game, super fun, no faults at all. It's a great game, I love it. On number 6, I will have to put the game I played the most after I was done with Breath of the Wild, and that is Splatoon 2. I never owned the first one for the Wii U, I don't know why. It was fun to play when I was with friends, but I bought this for the Switch and I played it so much. I was pretty good. I won a lot of times. It's a great game, I love it. I played it all the time online when Nintendo Switch Online was free. It's a great game. I love how unique it is in a way. So yeah, number 6. So we're getting down to the top 5 games I love the most on Nintendo Switch in my collection. And on number 5, I have Hyrule Warriors Definite Edition. And it's a great game. I love Zelda, so mwah. And I mean, it's like the game for the Wii U. I had it on the Wii U as well, but with the DLC and the 3DS Hyrule Warriors packed in one. It's a great game. With that said, on number 4, I'm gonna have to put Fire Emblem Warriors. I thought about which warrior games I'm gonna put over the other, and I do think when it comes down to it that I like Fire Emblem Warriors a little bit more. I did a video comparing these two games with each other, and go check it out if you haven't done it already. But I do like the triangle system in this game, and I did find the characters in it really fun to play with, and Pegasus and everything. It was really fun, so sorry Hyrule Warriors, but Fire Emblem Warriors is a little bit better in my personal opinion. So, top 3, what do we have? On number 3, I'm gonna put Fire Emblem Three Houses. This game is amazing. We're currently playing it. We have taken a little break and we're having a hard time getting back into it because we're lazy. But this is such a great game. I love it so much. And I haven't played any Fire Emblem games before this, except the Warriors game. But I love this game. And the characters are fun. The graphics, the art style, the music, it's amazing. It's such a good game. Game of the year for me. I love this game. I can't say much about it. I think I talked about the game a little bit in a video before. I don't know. Search it up or something. If you have watched this video through and you still don't know what games are left, I mean, come on. It's pretty obvious what games are left to put on this list. But on number 2, I'm gonna put Super Mario Odyssey. This game is amazing, as with a lot of other games on this list. But this one, it's really that good. I love it. When I first played it, I actually played through the whole main campaign, like the whole story mode, and I was like, that wasn't really that good. I didn't get it, because I think I went into it looking for another type of gameplay style, I don't know. But after I finished the story, that's when I really got into it. I loved playing it and getting all the moons. There was so much stuff to do. After the story mode, finally got what people were talking about with this game being so awesome, because it is. So if you haven't played this game already, firstly, what's wrong with you? But secondly, don't play it for the story mode, because that is kind of lousy, to be honest. It's the world, it's like just running around. That's fun with this game. I love it. Number 2 on my list. Now we are getting to number 1 on my list, where I rank all my Switch games I have in my collection. 31 games, plus 3 games I guess that I haven't even played a little bit of yet, but yeah, 31 games I have played. And this one is the best of the best. What game is it? Number 1? Well, of course, it is The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. This game is the best Zelda game I have ever played. It's the best game overall I have ever played. When I saw the trailers, I was like, this is gonna be a great game. And then I played it, and it was a great game. I put down so many hours into it. I have discovered so many places in it. I have seen so much scariness and wholesomeness, and I absolutely love it. And when I heard that there was gonna be a Breath of the Wild 2, oh my god, I cried. This is an amazing game. If anyone out there watching this doesn't agree on this being a top-notch game, you are fooling yourself. Sorry, but this is the best of the best. I can't see any game in the future topping this one on the Switch. I'm sorry, maybe Breath of the Wild 2, I guess. Maybe that one. But other than that, the other games here, Mario Odyssey, for example, number 2, it's a great game. But still, far from being even close to being number 1, because Breath of the Wild exists. This game is my bae. So, now I have ranked every single game on my Nintendo Switch, except the 3 games I haven't played. 31 games I have on my Nintendo Switch console. That's insane for me. I mean, games cost money. So I have spent a lot of money on these games. I haven't had this many games on any system before. The Nintendo Switch has so many great games. This list was really hard to make because there are so many and I love them so much in different ways, and now I have to rank them in a way. But I have done it, and that concludes my series of ranking all my Nintendo games per system. I have done the Nintendo 64, I have done the GameCube, I have done the Wii and the Wii U. Yes, I do have the DS and 3DS games that I haven't done a video about, but to be honest, there are a lot of those games that I didn't really at all enjoy getting into because small screen, if you know me, I don't do small screens, and I don't know, maybe I will do it in the future. But I do have a plan on remaking my first ever YouTube video where I ranked all my Nintendo 64 games. The video that started it all. Well, yeah, I'm gonna upload it in November when I uploaded my first video. So subscribe to my channel so you can check out that little remake and maybe compare the two. How much have I grown in 1 year on YouTube? It's gonna be interesting, it's gonna be fun. Remember to subscribe to my channel, like the video, please, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!